In this video, we'll talk about if-else-if statements, and we'll continue on with my newfound obsession about age. So public class if-else-if fun. Public static. All right, we'll just continue on in the same kind of idea. So we're going to get an age. Import the java.util.scanner, and then we'll build our scanner. And create an age variable for ourselves. We'll ask the user, how old are you? Alright, and then we'll read the age in using the next int. Okay, so then we'll have the age stored. Well, let's say we're writing a system for a casino. And I'm a little sensitive about this because I went into a casino. I was probably about 25 years old and I got ID'd. I couldn't believe it. Babyface. Anyway, let's say that the age to be able to go in the casino is 21, right? And so let's create an if statement that says whether or not a person can come into the casino. So if, and then in parentheses we put our condition, age is greater than or equal to 21, then do something. Now in this case we can say something like system.out.println, come on in. Okay, otherwise we can say using an else, system.out.println, you know, something smart, go back to grade school. All right, so that's our program right now. Let's go ahead and save that as is and try running it. How old are you? So if I say something like 25, then there I go with 25 again, come on in. Okay, if I run it again and I say how old are you and I say 20, then it tells me go back to grade school. Okay, so that's our conditional operators. If they're greater than 21, then come on in, else go back to grade school. But let's say that our casino has a policy that I don't know, you can't be too old. Okay, let's say we're tired of being liable for the heart attacks, and so we've decided that we've creating a new rule that if you get to be 100 years old, you can no longer come into our casino. This is so stupid. Okay, so there's a few different conditions now. One is if they're greater than 21, but then I want to add another condition. And so I can do that by saying, I'll get rid of this line for now, but saying else if. So we go from an if to an else if. So we're putting a second condition now. Else if the age is, well, see, that won't work now because age is greater than or equal to 21. Well, is 100 greater than 21? Yeah, it is, and so it actually will get into this statement. So let's try something different. Let's pick one end to start on. And so what I'm going to do is this. I'll say if the age, let's start the lowest number. So if the age is less than 21, okay, so if the age is less than 21, then we can make our statement that wasn't smart enough last time. Let's say go back to preschool this time. Anyone that's less than 21 that's listening to this has just been highly offended. Okay. Else if. Okay. What's our next condition? If they're less than 21, then what's the condition? Or if they're less than 21, we can. It's the go back to preschool. If what's our next thing we want to look at? Well, if the age is greater than or equal to 100, then we'll tell them go back to where? To the rest home. This is just me now. Okay. And then what's our other option? Well, the other option is if it's not either of those things, if it's not less than 21 and it's not greater than or equal to 100, then that means that they're in the zone for okay to come into the casino. So we can say else system.out.println, come on in and bring your money. All right, so we've now got three conditions, and all of these conditions are tied together, right? So now if I run this and I say, how old are you? If I say 20, it'll say go back to preschool. If I say 105, it'll tell me go back to the rest home. And if I say anything else, so if I say 45, then it says come on in and bring your money. Three different doors. Now these doors are mutually exclusive. You can only go in one or the other. And so we have to be careful when we're using if statements to not, or sorry, if else if statements to make sure that that's what we want, that you can only have one option. And again, we have to be careful because the else takes everything else into account. And if else if statements become a little bit trickier because you now have multiple conditions, and if by chance you forget a condition, the program's still going to function fine because there's an else attached to it. Let me just touch on one other thing I hadn't planned on, but this is another common error that sometimes people make. Sometimes we'll forget the else and just put if age is less than 21 and then if age is greater than 100. Now watch what happens when we do this. So I enter an age, 20. Let me enter a good age first. So let me enter 25. Then it will say come on in and bring your money. But if I enter an age like 20, watch what happens. It'll tell me both go back to preschool and come on in and bring your money, because this if statement operates all by itself. I haven't attached it to this one with an else. And so even though from a readability perspective, it looks like they're all part of the same thing because they're all smushed together in one block, what happens is it comes in and says, is this age greater than 21? Well, I entered a 20, or sorry, less than 21. I entered a 20, and so it's going to print out this message because age is less than 21. That's true. And so because it's true, I will execute this statement. Then I come to this if statement. If age is greater than or equal to 100. Well, 20 is not greater than or equal to 100, so it'll skip over this statement. But then because this else is attached to this if, it will say, oh, well, okay, it wasn't greater than or equal to 100, so I'm going to execute this else part of it, which is why it prints the come on in and bring your money. And so we have to be really careful. Personal preference, I tend to shy away from if, else, if statements because of experience of headaches that they've caused me in the past in programming. And that's not to say you shouldn't use them. There are perfectly good instances for using them. And in fact, some instances are really good for using them. They're perfect for them. But we just have to kind of evaluate the situation. I think sometimes there's a tendency to use these too much. But if we're going to do it, then we have our first condition And then we want to say else if the second condition, and then we can have an else attached. And all of these things now go together. They walk hand in hand. They're all part of one group that is determining conditionally what it is that's going to happen. All right, so hopefully that makes sense. And I guess there's nothing left to say than Spencer out.